This is great. Wow. Have a seat, everybody. Hello, New Hampshire Democrats. You guys look great. And for everybody still coming in line, please keep coming on in. Be patient. You'll get here. But what a great morning. What a great crowd. I just want to start by thanking Chairman Buckley and the NHDP staff for all of your hard work putting this historic convention together. And it is always great to be with my colleagues, Senator Shaheen, Congressman Pappas, Congresswoman Custer. They are doing great work for the people of our state. And I am so excited to join all of you in working to reelect them next year. I also want to thank our state Senate and House Democrats, executive council members, and all of the local leaders for the exceptional work that you're doing in communities throughout our state each and every day. Most of all, thank you, New Hampshire Democrats. Your values, your commitment, and your grassroots efforts will lead the way in 2020. We all know that New Hampshire does democracy better than anywhere else. And we engage in a way that recognizes the importance of spirited and respectful political dialogue. Our first-in-the-nation primary is an essential part of America's political process, and I am thrilled that our Democratic presidential candidates are here to talk with us today. We have an incredible field of candidates, and I know that Granite Staters are challenging them to present bold ideas and show how they will work to put our country on a better path forward. Our candidates would bring to the job different life experiences, different approaches, and some different proposals to solve some of our nation's most important problems. But every single one of our candidates believes this, that every American deserves access to quality health care without bankrupting their family. Every one of our candidates believes that climate change is real and a danger to our families and our planet. Every single one of our candidates believes that America should be a global leader standing for human rights, not with dictators. Every single one of our candidates believes that people have a right to go to school or the movies or church or shopping without the fear of a mass shooter. And every single one of our candidates believes that every person, no matter their gender, race, religion, no matter their sexual orientation, gender identity, no matter their health or disability status, deserves a government that treats them with dignity. And that is why next November, I will proudly cast my vote for our party's nominee. Enjoy this primary process, engage in it, and work passionately for the candidate who you support. And by the time we have a nominee, whoever he or she may be, please commit to joining me in doubling down on that passion to ensure that we take back the White House. But folks, friends, colleagues, we won't be able to truly address those critical priorities and more without a Democratic Congress. We need to maintain our majority in the House, and we absolutely must take back the United States Senate. That starts with re-electing the fabulous Jeanne Shaheen. Senator Shaheen's Senator Shaheen's bipartisan leadership, which I get to witness each and every day, is delivering results for people across our state. And of course, in addition to reelecting Jeanne, we need to reelect Annie Custer and Chris Pappas, too. And we also, not done yet, because we also need to ensure that we have a leader in the corner office in Concord who will fight for hardworking people. Our majorities in the State House, State Senate, and Executive Council are working tirelessly to move New Hampshire forward. We need to hold those majorities, and we need to elect a governor who won't thwart their efforts to strengthen our families and our way of life. But before voters go to the polls next November, and even before our first-in-the-nation primary, there are local elections that will have an enormous impact on the lives of Granite Staters. We need to do everything we can to re-elect Joyce Craig here in Manchester and all of our phenomenal candidates in cities and towns across the state. New Hampshire Democrats, there's no doubt that there is a lot of work ahead of us. But time and again, you have proven that grassroots energy here in the Granite State is truly an unstoppable force. So please, keep working, keep organizing, keep talking to your friends and neighbors, keep standing up for the values that we hold so dear. Together, we can build a brighter future for all Americans. Good luck, work hard, God bless the Granite State, and God bless the United States of America.